yet another torture test.
This link, but just maybe a month.
Well, we'll see if he lands. I think the New World Order is going to be recruiting some new guys after Starrcade, if there's any New World Order left like we know it.
That's just what I was going to follow up with. You're giving them way too much credit to think they're still going to be a viable force in wrestling after Starrcade 97 Sunday night. I think Sunday night, the end of 1997, marks the end of the New World Order.
From the heavyweight championship of the world to its TBS, TNT, corporate, political, ex-bigwig, to the so-called New World Order giant. They're all going down.
It's Sunday night on pay-per-view. If you haven't done so already, call your cable company or satellite provider and tell them I've got to have the granddaddy of them all, Starrcade 97. We'll be in Washington, D.C., our nation's capital, at the MCI Center for Sting and Hogan, Zbyszko and Bischoff, Giant and Nash, Paige Hennig, the whole Megillah.
Megillah? What's Megillah?
Starrcade 97 is December 28th on pay-per-view from the MCI Center in Washington, D.C. Finally, for once and for all, from the NWO, Hollywood Hulk Hogan takes on the man they call Sting. With Nitro at stake, Eric Bischoff takes on the living legend Larry Zbyszko, special guest referee Bret Hart. In a battle of the biggest men in the history of wrestling, the Giant faces the NWO's Kevin Nash at Starrcade 97. December 28th, it's on pay-per-view from WCW.
All right, you can see the referee, Mickey, telling the guy to get. I don't think he, who's that guy now? Megillah?
Megillah, yeah. No,
the
Barry,
Gorilla?
Barry Horowitz.
Well, I know it's Barry Horowitz, but who's this guy?
Oh, that's Barry Horowitz, and Bradley Kane is his opponent.
I'm confused on my Horowitzes.
Well, maybe you need to see a doctor.
Well, I tell you, I've been so focused on business. I mean, I've given up weeks of golf.
Uh-oh.
And when it's extra tray, I mean, let me tell you something, Scott. I hope Bischoff's in shape. I haven't felt this good since I was 25 years old. For the first time in my wrestling career, nothing hurts.
Uh-oh.
Nothing clicks. My back feels like a 20-year-old. My knees feel great. I'm gonna wipe up the floor with this idiot.
Everything you just said is well and good, but all I needed to hear was you've given up weeks of golf to train for Eric Bischoff. That's all I need to hear.
You don't know how hard that was.
I know, that's what I'm saying. You're serious about this thing with Bischoff. Boy, Sunday night, Eric Bischoff is gonna regret he ever learned to write, which allowed him to sign the contract to get into the ring with you.
What an idiot. Talk about the egos that get, I mean, countries have been ruined from good old Adolf to Napoleon back, down the whole path of time. And what gets into these people's minds? Do they really believe they're invincible?
Yep, they do.
Even Hogan finally realized he's not immortal anymore.
Thank goodness. It will all go down Sunday night on pay-per-view. And Barry Horowitz, nice drop kick on Bradley Kane. And Horowitz with a cover float over, hooks the leg and got the two count on Kane. Horowitz a veteran, Kane, not very long in the wrestling business, but that was a veteran maneuver, hanging on to the ropes.
Yeah, he was long enough to see Horowitz going up too soon, and this could be the blunder that cost him.
Kane, with a hip toss on Barry Horowitz, set his man, planted him nicely. Kane shoots him into the ropes. Horowitz off, nice backdrop on Horowitz. Moves in quickly, and the cover in the count of one. But he did hook the leg, he was ready.
Was he trying to leave?
I don't know. Kane brings it back in. Horowitz caught himself and then caught Kane with the elbow.
And a nice little trick. Horowitz looked over his shoulder and Kane's face was right there. Nice little move, just bring up that elbow. He's got him hooked.
Horowitz, chin lock, hooks the leg into a pinning combination. Nice amateur maneuver. Kane was going nowhere and Kane goes down to Barry Horowitz.
Hey, he was in that all fours position. Horowitz just slipped that quarter Nelson in, pulled the neck down as the man rolls over. Just lace that leg so they can roll through, and nice pin.
Barry Horowitz with a victory on WCW Pro. Here's how it went, legend.
Down with the one drop kick, even though he missed another one. But right here, watch the position here. Watch him slipping that quarter Nelson underneath. He stepped over, got the quarter, and hooks the leg. Makes it look easy.
Wraps up the leg and wins the match, does Barry Horowitz. Ultimo Dragon and Alex Wright are next.
Catches Dalton coming off the top rope like Dalton was Max Mini.
I've said it before, the Interrogator is the biggest man in the